Blackstone presents The Lake House by Kate Watterson. This book is read by Chris Andrew Ciulla. Chapter 1.
The roses were blooming. He knelt there in the grass by the flower bed in the only unshaded place near the house. The almost ghostly fragrance of the blooms intoxicating. Blood red and pale yellow and snow white. A well-tended garden was important, like a well-tended life. As soon as a bloom started to fade, he clipped it. Once something lost its beauty, there was no use for it. An apt analogy. He was going to kill his wife. It wasn't so much that he'd finally made up his mind. It was more that he'd known it for a long time. And was just now acknowledging it. It had been there, like a fly at a dirty window, buzzing around, pestering him. The sun was warm on his shoulders, and the sky above, a perfect azure blue. It wouldn't be hard. Maybe he'd even do it tonight. Quiet all around. The time was right. The only thing to mark the drive was a discreet lip of asphalt off the winding road, and Drew missed it the first time. It wasn't until they wound up on a loop back to the small county highway that they noticed it. It was fine with her, Lauren Matthews decided, as she looked out the window at the late afternoon sun dappling the crowding trees and sending shadows across the hood of the car. The later they were, the less time they would spend on this vacation. Every lost minute was a reprieve. She'd actually been grateful for gridlocked traffic on the interstate for the first time in her life. With a muttered expletive, Drew turned the car around on the narrow road, and they headed back. Rob has always said it was hard to see, and even he still misses it. I agree. Even though I've been here before, he's right. She glanced over. They had been dating about 6 months now, and she knew he was tense just by the set of his wide shoulders. Probably from the long drive. In profile, his familiar features were clean-cut, with a slight frown gathered between his fine brows, the sifted light through the forest coming in the window accenting the nice line of his lean jaw.
Thick, dark blonde hair, always a little unruly, gave him a surfer boy look, as did the honed athletic body beneath the Ohio State University t-shirt and tan shorts. Blue eyes the same color as the summer sky above the canopy of trees narrowed in concentration as they drove much slower back the way they had just come. It was popular opinion Andrew Fletcher was very hot, and she was a lucky girl. She was a lucky girl. That was part of the problem. He wasn't just attractive, but also intelligent and considerate. But shake it off. Stop thinking about it and maybe it will go away. Is that it? She pointed at a gap in the trees. There's a mailbox.
I think so. When he says private, he means it. Drew carefully pulled his expensive sports car into the narrow lane, which immediately curved to the right through the woods.
Yeah, this is it.
She had her first glimpse of the water. A sparkling peak as they slid around a corner. It was a half a mile at least before they spotted the cabin, and a few minutes later berthed the car next to a silver pickup truck also sporting Ohio plates. Some cabin, Lauren thought with amused assessment, trying to ignore the knot in her stomach. The place was stunning, with a pitched brow front 3 stories high overlooking the lake, all glass windows and huge decks on the lower and second level. The area around the structure had been carefully landscaped to look natural, but was free of the tangled shrubs and wild vines, and instead planted with a variety of ferns hanging delicate lacy leaves over the pine needles. The effect was expensive rustic at its finest, but then again, Rob had mentioned his uncle was filthy rich. Actually, he'd said in his reserved way, his uncle was quite well-to-do. Drew switched off the engine, took a look at his watch, and gave her one of his 100-watt smiles.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.